In a recent study done in hospitals in Delhi and Chennai, researchers found that a fungus called Candida auris is present in hospital premises and is likely to infect people who get admitted to intensive care units with prolonged hospital stay. Most vulnerable are those who are immunosuppressed patients like diabetics or organ transplant patients. This fungus is resistant to most available drugs prescribed by doctors. To date, three categories of drugs are available to treat fungal infections. These are azoles, amphotericin B, and echinocardins. The doctors tested if these available drugs can kill the fungus. They cultured the fungus in the lab on media with different antibiotics. They found that this fungus is resistant to frequently prescribed azoles and amphotericin and mildly susceptible to echinocardins. Doctors in routine practice prefer prescribing azoles and amphotericin B because echinocardins are expensive of the three antifungal drugs and it adds burden of cost to the patients.
We work on fungal infections, and these fungal infections occurs in patients who are admitted in intensive care units. So what we observed that a fungus which caused infections in these patients was newly recognized in many hospitals, and that was Candida auris. Candida auris, when we first isolated this fungus, we did the susceptibility testing and we observed that this fungus was resistant to antifungals.
This fungus is not limited to Indian hospitals alone and has been reported in hospitals of Pakistan, Japan, Korea, Spain, UK, South Africa, Venezuela, Colombia, and USA. This superbug calls for immediate action from public, medical community, and Indian authorities because more than 30% of patients that get infected by this fungus are likely to die. Realizing the seriousness of the situation, European and American disease control organizations have issued health alerts for strict monitoring of Candida auris cases. Doctors recommended specific preventive measures to deal with this fungus in India.
To prevent these infections, it is very important to take strict infection control practices rigorously, which include contacts of the patients to be segregated, which also includes a thorough cleaning of the hospital environment, the rooms where the patient was admitted, by either using hydrogen peroxide or by other agents. A terminal cleaning of those rooms is important before another patient is admitted in the same care unit.
This fungus can survive in the hospital for more than 3 months after an infected patient has left. In spite of the increasing number of cases of this superbug in the country, Indian doctors and hospital management believe that proper arrangement can be made to stop the spread of this bug well in time. Doctors have advised that hospitals should be cleaned rigorously after a patient is discharged.